All right. Good morning, and thank you for waking up today after a night of partying and dancing yesterday. This session is all about demystifying mobile-first commerce cloud sites with SFRA. It's probably one of the longest titles of any sessions in Dreamforce. The session won't be that long enough, and I'll try and keep things simple. My name is Gaurav Khetrapal. I work as Vice President at MetaCube, a product development and consulting partner. I'm also a Salesforce MVP and a certified technical instructor. And I teach Commerce Cloud in APAC. And just to make sure that the person who's presenting is the same on stage. And in case you're able to recognize me, I had my moment of fame yesterday. And as soon as I said that, the slides are gone. So I was with Mark up there. I've actually been speaking at Dreamforce for the last 7 years. And the least Mark could do is feature me in his keynote. So I'm happy about that. So going back, although we'll talk a lot about buying, purchasing, and this session is all about e-commerce, do not make any buying or purchasing decisions on the Salesforce stock based on what you hear or see over the next 15 years, or you are the one who's fully responsible for it. Okay, so what do I plan to cover? We'll start off with an introduction to Commerce Cloud. We'll talk about why mobile first. We'll de-jargonize SFRA, what SFRA is, why Commerce Cloud needs to move to a mobile architecture. We'll do a slightly more deeper dive into SFRA. We'll look at some typical use cases. I'll do some demos, and then we'll wrap it up with a few references and questions and answers. So before we begin, I always like to know who's in the audience. So any developers in the house, a show of hands? All right, good to see you. Developers are a species who have always been taught it's not a bug, it's a feature. This is something which is programmed into our DNA, and I've successfully been using this trick for the last 20 years. It's worked reasonably all right. Designers in the house? Okay, so designers are people who talk in terms of style sheets, who talk in terms of media queries. One of my favorite design tags is obese, which you can see I am. The width is 200%, and the overflow is clearly visible. Okay. End users, these are people, if you give them a good user experience, they are happy. If you do not give them a good user experience on an e-commerce site, they are not happy, and in turn, you are not happy. Okay. So with some context, let's talk about Commerce Cloud, what it is. Commerce Cloud, or e-commerce in general, does not need any introduction. If we talk about the richest man in the world, Jeff Bezos, he made fortunes out of e-commerce. Some statistics which I actually pulled out of a slide from Salesforce. More than 50% of e-commerce traffic these days comes from mobile devices. There has actually been 100% annual growth in social commerce for the last 3 years. And more than 50% in-store sales, which are the offline sales, are actually inspired by digital in some manner or the other. And when we talk about touch points, it says 25% purchases span multiple touch points. A touch point is basically how you're making the purchase, whether that's through a phone, a tablet, through the store. So more than a quarter of the transactions actually involve some digital touch point. I cannot go into a lot of detail due to time constraints, but I do want to talk a little bit about Commerce Cloud roadmap, and I've actually been teaching Commerce Cloud for the last 2.5 years. So last year was a breakthrough year for Commerce Cloud. We integrated Einstein. We did some critical pieces which were missing, like order management. This year, it's significant because we realized that something is inherently flawed in the architecture that we have. So that's why we had something called Mobile First Reference Architecture. We also called it MFRA. And the name didn't quite fit the marketing philosophy that Salesforce had, so it was changed to Storefront Reference Architecture, or SFRA, which is now what it's called. And then in 2018, you'll also see a number of Einstein-related enhancements, like search recommendations, search dictionaries. But for this presentation, I'm actually going to focus only on MFRA, or SFRA as we call it. So from a platform perspective, Commerce Cloud is organized in the sense you have multiple touch points, which you can see on the top. You have smartphones, tablets, desktops, kiosks from where the users can buy. You have digital experiences. You have in-store experiences. Then you have a whole integration layer, which is supported through something which is called an open commerce API, or popularly called as OCAPI in developer jargon. You have Einstein, which is used for product recommendations. So for example, somebody buys a mattress. Einstein would then recommend probably something smarter than a pillow, but a pillow is a good example as well. Predictive emails based on your buying history. Einstein is able to actually determine what is it that you're likely to buy, when is a good time that you're likely to buy it, so it will send out predictive emails. And then we have this shared view of the core e-commerce data model that is common to pretty much all e-commerce platforms. You have orders, you have inventories, products, price, customers, promotions, contents. And then at the end of it, at the bottom layer, you actually have the DevOps aspect, which is, again, a key aspect of all Salesforce products. So you have reliability, security, a multi-tenant architecture, and a global release model, which ensures that everybody is on the same release. So why mobile first? I mean, what's wrong with the current architecture? Commerce Cloud has been around for a while. It's been selling wonderfully well. We have a number of Fortune 500 customers as well. The reason for that is simple. Our habits are changing. I was reading a statistic a while back that there are more mobile devices on planet Earth than humans. And this image is actually organized in terms of the number of devices that are present. So we have more phones than tablets. We have more tablets than laptops. And we have more laptops than desktops, which are on the verge of extinction. So whatever we were doing on desktops a decade back is now typically being done on mobile. And that's why a mobile first is no longer a luxury. It's more of a necessity. One of the other reasons, and I pulled this out of a site called isfluent.com, 57% users would actually not recommend a site with a bad mobile experience to a business or a business with a bad mobile site to anybody else. 40% users will actually turn to a competitor after a bad mobile experience. 23% of adults would actually curse their phone when a site doesn't work, and they'll use adjectives, which unfortunately I cannot use on stage. But we've all been through that stage. OK, so another reason, and I pulled in a couple of my favorite quotes. The mobile experience that we get is typically very different from the desktop. Somebody said that our minds are like parachutes. They only function when they are open. If you are not providing a consistent interface on a desktop interface and a mobile device, your users are not likely to stick around. Similarly, mobile design is actually a very key aspect. And the legendary Steve Jobs, he once said, design is not what it looks or feels like. Design is how it works. It's applicable to all sites. It's applicable to how smartphones are designed. But more so, it's applicable to e-commerce. Because e-commerce, the user experience is the primary key. You have a very small window of retention for the users. And why mobile first? This is one of the popular paid news sites which was launched. And if you can see, it's almost impossible for a human being to navigate this on a desktop. And you can just imagine doing this on a mobile device. So this is a case study of how not to do a design for a desktop or a mobile. Let's actually talk a little bit about SFRA. Before I do that, site genesis is something which we have as a legacy application, which the current architecture supports. And if you are a developer, you have probably seen this block diagram of MVC, the model view controller, a popular interview question as well, several times. So what exactly is the limitation with this architecture, and why do we actually need to change it in the first place? So the views, in this case, we have ISML templates, which are the internet store markup language. Those are bulky. Even if you include one template into the other, the rendering itself is not very efficient. The models actually do not represent the API. They represent the script API of the demandware platform. So it's not a pure model implementation in terms of MVC. And then there is no separation of concerns. So your controllers are interacting with your model. The views are also interacting with your model. And the controller also interacts with the platform data as well as the storefront. This is exactly not what MVC is meant to be. This is what a site genesis application typically looks like. Works perfectly on the desktop, not so good on the mobile, and actually we'll see a demo of it in some time as well. So what changed with the SFRA, and what was the motivation for SFRA? So sometime in 2016, Demandware, or Salesforce now as it's called, they realized that we are not providing an optimal experience to the users on mobile. So they surveyed over 2,000 customer stores, some big ones, including Puma, including Wolverine. And then they built out a set of best practices for a user's optimal experience on mobile. These best practices were compiled into something which we now call as SFRA, earlier called as MFRA. It's built in a manner so that customizations are fast, the updates are seamless. And from an architectural perspective, it's very, very similar to what we had earlier. You have all the DevOps things like multi-tenancy, scalability, security, reliability. Then you have the API layer. And on the front end now, instead of having the legacy interface, you have something which is responsive, which works just as well on mobile, tablets, as well as desktops. So talking about SFRA from an MVC perspective, this is a more pure implementation. The user typically invokes something on the UI, which triggers a controller, which manipulates your model, and which then in turn updates the view. And the view is finally what the user sees. So it's not like your views are also interacting with your models and your controllers are also interacting with your model. How do you migrate from the legacy architecture to SFRA? It's fairly simple. We use a concept called cartridge path, which essentially determines whether you are using the legacy architecture or SFRA. So if you end up using a cartridge which is called App Storefront Base, which is where the SFRA resides, you can actually port your site from the legacy architecture to SFRA. This is what an SFRA site looks like. And let me first talk through the use cases, and then I'll actually come to a demo. So why is SFRA important? Why the legacy architecture is no longer sufficient? It was not possible to build responsive e-commerce sites using the legacy architecture. That is exactly the pain point which SFRA solves. It is also extensible via link cartridges. So Commerce Cloud has something called a link marketplace, where if you do not want to reinvent the wheel, you can just use cartridges which other developers or other companies have built and use them in your site. And then it finally leverages something which is very important, which is it has a set of mobile APIs, so you can actually use features which are mobile-centric, like location, like accelerometer, and even Siri. Okay, so moving on, some of the famous or some of the prominent customers who have actually been using Commerce Cloud and who've actually moved on to SFRA already: Puma, Wolverine, Rackroom Shoes, and a few others. All right, so let's actually look at a small demo. So this is what site genesis, or the earlier site, would look like. If you were to navigate to a particular product, you would typically do it through some categories on the top. You would go to a subcategory, and then you would go to a product. You'll probably select the appropriate size, and you'll add it to the cart. And once you've added it to the cart, you can check it out. Okay. While this is great on desktop, it's actually not an optimal mobile experience, because we'll see how it works on a mobile device. This, in contrast, is what is built with SFRA. So if you see closely, your tabbed interface has changed to something which will show up a little better on mobile. And if I were again to go to a particular product, so for example, I want to buy a suit for Mark, because he featured me in the keynote, and I want to gift it to him. This is what it looks like on the desktop. And so let's actually look at how this thing works on the mobile. So I have both these sites on a mobile as well. So let me actually go to the home page first. So this is the legacy interface. It's kind of usable on a mobile device. But as soon as I switch orientations and I go to some products, you'll see that it's not really the ideal interface. So for example, if I go to a product, and I try to open the product detail. And the site itself is not very responsive. So if I have to choose a size, some of the size buttons are actually not clickable. The add to cart button is not clickable. But if I do the same thing on the site which has been built with SFRA, I get an interface which I can relate to more on a tablet. So for example, I have these crisp images which are styled accordingly, responsively, based on the fact that I'm on a tablet. And if I then go to a product, I'll again buy a suit for Mark, but this time on a new interface. So this is a much better user experience on a tablet as compared to a mobile device. I can easily choose the size. This again uses something which is a drop-down, which I'm used to seeing on a tablet device as compared to popping a button on a desktop. Okay, and the experience is again very similar if I'm on the iPhone X. So I go to a category, enough of Mark, I'll choose a women's dress this time. So if I go to a category, I have 3 minutes. I'm not sure if 3 minutes is enough to choose a women's dress, but we'll try. And then I can choose a size. Again, it's similar. I can choose the quantity. Once I've done that, I can add it to my cart. Okay? And the same interface on a smartphone, which was the legacy interface. You can see it's fairly difficult to use. I mean, I am barely able to see some of the options here. And if I go to a category again, some of the images, they are scaling out. So it's not really an optimal user experience. Okay. So SFRA, it gives you the best of both worlds on either desktop, mobile, tablets. So you don't need to really think about building a site for the desktop first and then porting it over to mobile. So if I can get back to my slides. So a few references. Let's actually do a recap first. So why mobile first? Mobile is the way to go forward. Everything will be mobile in the years to come. So you cannot actually build a site which is just for desktop. It has to be mobile compliant and mobile first. We learned a little bit about Commerce Cloud. There are multiple sessions at the conference today as well, if you want to learn more about Commerce Cloud. We looked at the legacy architecture, site genesis. We talked about SFRA, and we looked at some use cases. If you want more information, we have a portal called Exchange, which is basically the source of truth for all Commerce Cloud developers. And then there is a YouTube video, which is about 20-25 minutes, which talks about an introduction to Commerce Cloud. So that is pretty much what I had. Thank you for attending this session, and enjoy the rest of the conference. Thank you.